Today I have the vet coming to do a relatively common procedure on my mare Nika. Basically what's been going on is Nika got an infection in her uterus. So today she'll be flushed out with a sterile saline solution and then she'll be getting a Caslick procedure done. So let's go and check it out.
Dirty.
She's in heat.
Well, that'll be perfect. Your uterus will be nice and open. Your cervix.
Yeah, she's always been real messy when she's in heat. Like to the point where I won't ride her because she'll be raw.
Huh.
She's always had bad heat cycles. But she's never been crabby or anything. She's always very lovey.
Solution to pollution is delusion. That's the theme of today. So we're gonna do a little bit. See how that's sucked in there?
Oh, yeah.
So that's what we're gonna hopefully fix. I mean, you can see we've got some pooling in there.
Oh, wow. Jeez.
So some urine pooling, and then I think some of this.
Mm-hmm.
Wash is gonna.
That's terrible.
She was just asking for a problem.
Yeah, like she's got poop in there. You see that?
Oh, yeah. Wow. Oh, poor baby.
I don't know if you can see that, but.
This is terrible. Pretty common, hey?
Yeah, especially after a foal, it just changes. And just the flow of things.
And when you notice them sunk in like that, that's typically, I know another mare that's way worse than she is.
Yeah, and it depends, because some of them sink in, but they still have a nice seal.
Okay.
And some of them sink in and they
don't have a good seal.
Don't have a good seal. We're gonna flush some stuff and then I'm gonna leave an antibiotic in there.
Oh, okay. Now keep her on the antibiotics that she's been on?
Yeah, I think we're just at about at our 10 days.
Yeah.
So this is the uterine tube. This is a sterile glove. We're gonna put this in and then there's a little balloon on the end here that once we're past the cervix, I'm gonna push some air in there. It's gonna balloon up and kind of make a seal. And then we're gonna start to flush some stuff through there. Ready up there?
Yep.
Got a lot of air up in here. Past the cervix. Good news, this stuff didn't come rushing out at us. It can happen. She's got a nice big open cervix because she's in heat. So this is not going to be a perfect seal, but it'll be good enough. All right.
Is that just like saline?
Yep, sterile fluids. It's an isotonic sterile fluid. I usually give it IV, so that same sterility. She's got a nice big uterus, so she's taking up the entire liter.
Yeah, she has to. My arms are ginormous. Poor thing. She could have had a small foal for her first one.
That would have been nice.
I should have bred her to an Arabian. A Welsh. Actually, that's what I'm thinking about doing with Blossom.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I found a really cute Welsh.
Now we're just draining all that stuff back out.
Oh, so it all comes back out now?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, cool. So you might see like little bits of yuck in there.
Yeah, I see a couple floaties. Not a ton. Which is good. There's a nice big pocket sometimes. It's this big balloon filled with fluid, and sometimes you have to move to find the fluid. So you've got a nice flow.
So you siphon it all right back out.
Yep. In a perfect world, it all comes right back out. And once we've got this out, we'll do our second one. And then we'll put the antibiotics in and leave that in there.
For Ted.
This will help her push out.
Cool.
Everything we don't want in there. In case she just starts spewing. Nothing really gross. Just some fuzzies in there.
More floaters.
Some floaters. Not too bad. You can kind of see them.
Yeah, it's a lot cleaner than I thought it was going to be.
Which is good.
Yeah.
Which means our work is a little bit cut out for us.
Good.
There we go. That's the oxytocin making her uterus kind of cramp up.
That is also a terrible feeling. That worked fast.
It works very fast, yeah. That looks like the rest of our fluids. I'm gonna give her some Banamine as well, because this whole process is not very fun.
A little painful.
No, it's crampy, I'm sorry. That was step one.
Cool.
They're all flushed out.
What's that? Oh, more air?
I'm going to pull the air out.
Oh, okay.
Pull the tube out. Here's that little bubble.
Oh, cool.
All blown up. Her cervix was so big that this did an okay job. That wasn't the tightest seal.
Okay.
Yeah. So she can hear her sucking the air in.
Yeah. Ivory soap.
Ivory soap. Can't use it in my house.
You're like, yeah, that's penises and horse veg.
Yeah,
oh, she's blowing bubbles.
It's a very specific smell that I no longer can. But it's very nice because it's not like.
No. Bodhi's gonna think that's hilarious.
I think it's hilarious.
Yeah.
Do you have to try to get like all of the air out before you sew her up, or that doesn't really matter?
You can try, but it's hard. In theory, we're just preventing her from sucking more in. She's gonna keep pushing stuff out for a little bit. The next step is to block it so she doesn't feel it. To block it, I'm gonna put some lidocaine in there. Unfortunately, she will feel the first poke. She might make a move.
What a good girl.
Always go from the other side.
Easy.
So she doesn't necessarily take it out.
Oh.
Felt that one a little bit. So it looks like when she had Manzer, she had some damage.
There was some tearing, yeah.
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 I think it's part of her problem.
Yeah. Now, is that something that can be stitched up after?
It is, yep.
Yeah.
Like, usually.
I'm confident that I asked. I would have asked. I'm pretty sure I did. Maybe it wasn't like, I don't know.
It depends. Some people want to wait.
Yeah.
Because you don't want it to be contaminated.
Yes.
And there's a lot of changes that happen.
Yeah.
As everything kind of shrinks down. But yes, can be fixed sooner. But who knows if that would have fixed her problem or if
right.
We'd end up here anyway.
Now we're using iodine?
Yeah, a little surgical scrub. We'd be fine to use the soap too. Monster.
I know.
So if you want to see, obviously now it's all puffy because I put the lidocaine in there.
Oh.
But see the rip there?
Oh, yeah.
Instead of normally down here, it's like just a straight line.
So all that tore.
Definitely a significant portion of it. So, we'll sew it back together. So I just pinched her and she didn't react. Very flippy. So just because she doesn't feel it here doesn't mean at any point she might change her mind. So if she just watch herself in case she decides she's over this. Part of it, sorry. She said, oh, I think I felt that part.
Yeah, if there's anything you need me to do, let me know. Ooh. Definitely felt that.
Okay.
More sedative?
Yeah, we'll give her a little bit more sedative, and then while that's kicking in, I'm just going to block a little bit more. No need for anybody to be a hero. Yeah, just feeling that now.
She's one that usually needs extra sedative for teeth and stuff, too.
Mm-hmm.
bloopiness is all lidocaine.
What?
All this bloopiness is lidocaine.
Oh, really?
She was so fussy, I was like, you're getting a lot.
Yeah. Shove it in there.
So, yeah. So we still have all of this that she can pee out of, so this shouldn't impact that, but now this is all solid.
Okay, so let me get that on video good.
Nice, did she?
Yeah, it came together pretty nicely. It's very poofy right now. It will shrink down. And one of the things, like the complication that we might see is that we might have a gap somewhere. And if that happens, let me know and I can just come and do a quick gap fix.
Okay. All right. Well, I'll keep a real close eye on it. Now, do I need to do anything, watch for anything?
Nope, not really.
Okay. It's an okay area. I shouldn't have to worry about the flies or...
I mean, if you want, you can put some SWAT on either side.
Yeah, okay.
But she's going to poop right on top of it anyway.
Yeah.
So.
She going to be sore for a while?
I gave her a dose of Banamine, so she should be good for today. I mean, you could give her some tomorrow.
Okay.
Or a little scoop of Bute would be fine.
Okay. And keep her on the antibiotics until she's out.
Yeah.
Poor Nika. She needed a lot of sedative. She's like, feed, I smell feed. Look at that lip. Oh gosh, honey, I'm so sorry. Oh. Hey, Meek, you gonna go in there? Go ahead, honey. She's like, that step is a doozy. I don't know if I can do it. Hey, baby. Even her eyeballs are puffy.
Well, that involved a little bit more than I was expecting, but it was super interesting. So I really hope that Nika is going to be feeling a lot better now and she'll be back to herself in no time. Thanks so much for watching. See you in the next one. Bye.